we will try to understand three to four things. Number one, what is anatomy? Question number one. Number two, we will look what is veterinary anatomy. We also look what is human anatomy, and fourth one important thing, that is comparative anatomy. Technically, this lecture is all about introduction to anatomy. Introduction to anatomy. This is the primary heading of this topic, introduction to anatomy. You know, normally when we study any term or terminology, we want to figure it out, what really we do. We do what? We do try to look at the word itself. So you have word is anatomy. In anatomy, for me, the root word is what? Tomb. This is the root word. This is the root word, okay? Tomb. This ala is actually perfex, you know? This is Y here, maybe. Perfex. Point is that tomb is the root word. This actually, anatomy is belong to, I think, this is the Greek word. Which word? Greek words. So root word is tomb. If you look at the meaning of tomb, we have meaning like this, cutting. You know, because you people, this, I believe, this terminology, this word anatomy is not new for you people. So I really want to listen if you want to define what is anatomy. Yes, please. You know what is anatomy? Leave it. Just define anatomy. What is anatomy?
Study of internal structures.
Anybody want to define anatomy? Rise your hand. Yes, please.
Study of the structure of the body. Study of the structure of the organization of the body.
First of all, write down, this study of internal structure of body is the one of the false or wrong definition of anatomy. Please do not define anatomy. It is a study of internal structure of body. Anatomy is a vast subject. Don't make it confined only to the internal structures. So this definition, study is the internal structure of body, is completely wrong. Okay? First thing is to clear that. Number two is that for anatomy, the most common, the most simple definition is that study of structure of the body. The one-liner definition, which is much common, is that study of structure of the body. You know, there is a story. Because here, the word anatomy is literally meaning here, cutting. Literally meaning here, cutting. Why mean process? You know, ala mean cut apart. That's it mean apart or up. Okay, so that's mean this whole anatomy word, the process of cutting apart, the process of cutting apart. Here you are defining study of structure of body. So the, you know, is we have two different things. Word anatomy meaning is what? Cutting apart. Here you are defining study of structure of a body is anatomy. You know, everything you for anatomy you better understand first biology. To understand anatomy, you need to understand. You know why? Because these two words are special. Structure and body. If you are talking about living organism, study, if you are talking about medical science or biology, if we are considering anatomy is a branch of biology. Anatomy is a branch of biology. So from this word, body means what? Organism. What does it mean? Organism. You know, can you define what is organism? Listen again carefully. Because this organism mean, you know, what is the definition of biology here? The simplest definition is study of life. So if something have life, we call that is living thing. We call that is? That means that living thing is actually the organism. That living thing is actually the? It could be a unicellular organism. It could be a multicellular organism. But you know what things make organism organism? A term which is known as biological order. Point is that organism have high level of biological order. This is the definition of organism. Organism have high level of biological order. What is biological order? Biological order is actually an organized, recognizable pattern of anything. Organized, a recognized pattern. You know what really happened? If you look on an organism, a living body, let's take an example of human being. Every structure, everything have a pattern. Every structure, everything have a pattern. If you start very basic, there is a pattern. Cell togetherly form tissue, tissue togetherly form organism. Similarly, there is a pattern. Blood vessels, heart and blood, they togetherly, they are arranged in a classical biological order to form cardiovascular system. The organ of digestive system arranged in a classical biological order to in a pattern to form a digestive system. So there is a what? There is a recognizable pattern. There is a recognizable. If there is a breakdown of a pattern, for example, blood vessels, heart. This is in a pattern. They are forming what? Cardiovascular. Something is breakdown. This what will be happen? There will be a biological disorder. There will be the. This disorder is actually coming from where? There is a disturbance in any in pattern. So you will have what? Biological? Point is that for organism, every structure of organism have a pattern that making a high level of biological orders. This high level of biological order is making what? You know, these term biological order, pattern, they all are actually applying on this word on structure. This word on? What is a structure? Anything which have mass, which have color, shape, size, you can call structure. Structure can be living structure, can be non-living. But because we are our focus giving to the biology, we are considering anatomy is the branch of, so we are giving importance to the living structure. We are giving importance to the, so in that case, in the biological order or pattern of cardiovascular system, for us, blood vessels, heart, they all are what? They are structures. They all are what? They have some mass, they have some shape, they have some color and some size. But to make an organism, they have a biological order. To make an organism, they have a biological order. So anatomy is that we study of structure of body. We study structure of body or living body or organisms. So mean anything in the body is structure, we study. But we know that all these structures have a pattern. They are on the level of biological order. That's what does it mean? That's mean in a simple word, we study normal position, normal location, and thus all structure in normal conditions. If there is abnormality, that's mean there may be a biological disorder. Biological disorder. There is breakdown in pattern. But when you are studying anatomy, you give importance to the structure should be under biological order or under biological pattern. That's clear. But when you look here, you will surprise. Oh, you define anatomy is a vast story, the study of structure of biology of organism. But you look on that word, you will surprise. The meaning of this word is to cut apart. They're completely different with this statement. I can tell you another word, which is called as dissection. Okay? In that word, in dissection, you know, section actually, di and section. This section is also mean to cutting, also mean cutting. Di mean up apart, okay? Point is that the word dissection and word anatomy both have similar meaning. If you break, this is belong to Roman word, okay? This is a Roman, this is a Greek. Both have similar meaning. The meaning of anatomy is the what? To cut apart. Meaning of dissection is to cut apart. Point is that the root word for anatomy is tome. Root word for dissection is section. Both have meaning cutting. Both have meaning cutting. You know why this different meaning and this different words? Because when people start study different living organisms, their structure, people take lot of importance in medicine, and that was the Greek and Roman era. Okay? How people first explore the human body or animal body, how they first look at the structure. For that purpose, they actually dissect the cadaver. They actually, no, you nowadays you study anatomy like this, you know, you have a great textbooks which have a different angle of picture of hearts, different angle of the picture of limbs. So you take help from textbook, you take help from lot of video tutorial. But just imagine that time when this study was bigger, there was not such facilities, there was no textbook. There was no video tutorial. So people want to find out what is inside of body, what is body's makeup of. The way was only that if they find any dead animal, a cadaver. So they have to dissect that one. They have. That's why this word come in the part cutting. They have to cut that. So from that they give, if what really happened, well, they are cutting and dissecting animals, they are not treating animals. Okay, they are not looking for the function of animal. The target was only one. What animal is actually made up of? What kind of structure animal have? What kind of structure organism have? So this discipline become anatomy. This discipline become a, so the Greek people, they were giving word cutting to anatomy, and the Roman people give a dissection. But when, you know, after the time, the size grow, the so many new techniques come, so many new way to come there. The all knowledge is divided into many branches in different disciplines. So up to nowadays, we know anatomy is actually deals with the study of the structure. Anatomy will deal the study of the normal structure of the organism. And you know, but still, you know, this word dissection is present. And nowadays, if somebody asks, there is a difference between anatomy and dissection, you will say, yes. You know why? Because we believe anatomy is a discipline. Anatomy is a major subject, a branch of biology. Okay, we deal with the structure. What is dissection? Dissection is still known as a procedure, a biological procedure which we use to study the different part of the body. Because still nowadays we have cadaver, we do dissect. If you want to, okay, textbook you can observe heart, okay, you can observe it video tutorial. But if you want to a real heart of animal, if someone denote cadaver, you have to cut that. That cutting, that procedure in lab till date is known as dissection. So dissection is still present. Anatomy is now become a big thing. A big discipline of the biology, a vast discipline which covers the all living organism structures. You know, structures, if you look at the biologically, structures are so much now. Cell is a structure, tissue is a structure, organ is a structure, organ system is a structure. So organization of cell, organization of tissue, when you are studying this organization under normal pattern, you know, under? Okay. Or under biological order. So what are you doing? You are actually studying anatomy. You are actually studying anatomy. So that is the difference between, that's the two things, you know. How anatomy and dissection is same, same meaning. How they are different now. If you go 100 years back, they are same word, you know. But nowadays they are little different. But they are still attached to each other. You cannot study anatomy without dissection. You cannot study anatomy, the proper anatomy, without dissection. So this is actually still the best definition is still that some people say scientific study of the structure of organism is called anatomy. That's okay. Some people say study the structure of the living organism is anatomy. That's okay. Some people say the organization, cellular organization, tissue organization, organ system organization is called as of an organism is called as anatomy. Yes, because these tissue, organ, system, cell, they are all structures. They all are structure organized in a biological order or in a biological pattern in the body. That's clear.
Yes,
okay, move on. Because you people are in veterinary anatomy, veterinary institute, so you give lot of focus to veterinary anatomy. So because no veterinary subject is no way to specify too much, they have special branches. So veterinary anatomy is for here you need to understand word veterinary. What is word veterinary? Okay? What is word? No, there is another word, veterinarian. I hope one day you will be a renowned veterinarian. So veterinarian means simple if you mean animal doctor. A person who deals with animal, a person who do the treatment of animal is known as veterinarian. So word veterinarian actually or veterinary means to do something with animal, to work with animal, to work with animals. Something related to animals. So this is what? So here in veterinary anatomy, in a simple is that we study the anatomy of animal. But I want to make more specific for you people. There is a lot of animals. Mostly in veterinary sciences, we study domesticated animal. We study in the different part of the different country, there is a different animal which are considered as domestic. But some are common. For example, dog and cat, all over the world, they are pets or domesticated animal. Cattle, sheep, goat, there is the ruminant class. They are also known as domesticated animal. Horse, in some region of the world, there is camel. Birds, you know, chicken, they are all known as what? Domesticated animals. So point is that in veterinary, you know, some people also call veterinary anatomy as animal anatomy. That's true. If you do want a simple definition, that's okay. Veterinary anatomy is actually animal anatomy. You are studying the anatomy of the animals. That's it. Clear. If you want more specific, you are studying the anatomy of the domesticated animals. That is what? Veterinary anatomy. That's clear. So like if you, human anatomy is what? You are studying the anatomy of human beings. You are studying the structure of human beings. That is what? Human anatomy. Comparative anatomy is important one. You know why? Comparative anatomy is far, there is two different meanings. One is that comparative anatomy, that means you are making a comparison of all different organisms. All? For example, you take the example of heart of different organisms, how they look like. Take the example of stomach, you know, in the different organism, they are different or same. Take the example of limbs, the arrangement of bones in limbs, they are different or same. What we do in comparative anatomy, we study similarities and dissimilarities among different animals. Among different animals. For here, especially in veterinary anatomy, all we study this comparison among the domesticated animals. Among the domesticated animal, what kind of difference they have. That's clear. So this is what actually comparative anatomy. That's clear. One thing I want to add more here. The whole story, the whole knowledge of anatomy can be divided into three parts, into three divisions. One is known as grass anatomy, okay? Other is known as histology. Next is known as developmental anatomy. You know what grass anatomy means? Macroscopic anatomy. A structure which you can observe with naked eye. For example, a heart of any animal, you can observe the shape of heart, the color of heart, the location of heart, you can observe with naked eye. This is what? Grass anatomy. But the heart is made up of what? Cardiac muscles. To study that cardiac muscle, the cell of cardiac muscle, you need an instrument to increase the power. You need a microscope. That knowledge will be come under the histology, which is also known as microscopic anatomy. Okay? And finally, developmental anatomy is also known as embryology. This is, you know, animal have different developmental stages. Okay? Up in the inside the uterus of mother, from zygote up to the birth, there is a phase of development. Even there is after, there is a development after birth. So if you are studying the development of structure, if you are studying a development in structures, what kind of development structure do? That is known as what? Developmental anatomy or embryology. That's clear. Yes.